Generic greetings and welcome to Preview plus Space Hulk Ascension Edition. This is sort of a quasi-sequel to the game that came out in August of 2013, that being a straight port of the board game, and I thought it was okay. There was some issues with it, but overall it was fun. This is more of an evolution of that premise. So it's taken the Space Hulk board game, which is basically one person plays some marines that turns up on a drifting rock and loads of ships that have been crashed into it and all sorts of things, and there are loads of aliens on the other side. You have certain objectives. If you die or don't complete your objectives, you lose. That's the premise of the game, but they've evolved that, so now you can level up your characters, you can give them pieces of equipment, you can give them different skills and abilities, you can pick one of three chapters now instead of just one, and there's several campaigns, so overall just more. So I think I'll just jump in and show you a little bit of it. If you're not really aware of what the game is, it's basically a turn-based tactics game. I think that accurately describes it. So we'll click continue game. Boarding prod 7, prepare to die. I mean launch. Right, so I'm currently playing the Ultramarines. However, we've got a campaign map. We can see we can play the Ultramarines Hammer and Anvil campaign, the Space Wolf Fall of Jotunheim campaign, and we've got the Sin of Damnation, which is the Blood Angels. I've actually gone, I think I've completed about 3 or 4 missions in the Space Wolf campaign before this was reset. I was playing it before it was fully released, so that was all reset and such. So I've only just got back into it doing the Hammer and Anvil. I've just clicked on that, we'll click confirm. So we'll go to our mission map, and we can see I've only done the first mission of this, so we're going to do the second one, which is Cut Off Retreat. So it's currently incomplete. Now, you will get different places you can go. You can pick different areas as it branches out and such. This is supposed to be the side of the Space Hulk. We can see our loadout of our Marines, so each one has a set of skills and abilities. So we can see this guy here, Demetrius, he has a Storm Bolter, he has a Power Fist. We've got skills, we can see he's only got one skill currently, the other two are locked. Appearance, you can change like his head, so we'll actually put a helmet on. And I never understood why, if you're actually breaching a ship that might not have atmosphere, you would just take your helmet off. That's for the stupid. Attributes, we can see they have ballistic skill, weapon skill, agility. They all change how the character works. So if you want to, say, level them up in toughness, you can hopefully, you know, tank them off and such. Not generally a good idea, as people playing the game, no, you generally want to stay away from all the beasties that are trying to eat you. And you can go to equipment and change things as well. So currently we've got a servo skull scanner. We can pick between things like that's a teleport homer, power field generator. Now you can get different characters, and as far as I've seen, you can get things like librarians and all of that sort of thing, and force swords. I personally haven't got that far, however. Right, I think we'll just go straight in. Obviously, there's different classes as well. There's a heavy with a massive flamer. Lovely, lovely. Let's just go to mission loadout, and we're just going to jump into this mission. So, objectives, plant explosives at the two escape pods. So, we'll select that, and we'll gun straight in. So, jump in. Hopefully, we won't die. Bit of a briefing here on what's going to happen and our objectives and such. So we'll just continue that.
Sergeant of the squad, accept your orders.
Okay, no problem. So it's going to give our objectives with a big bang. Boom, boom, boom. Michael Bay. Bang, 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 bang. So plant explosives at the two escape pods. Deploy terminators at these zones. Deploy at least 3 terminators there and there. Okay. And our mission info is destroy the savior pods and prevent the gene stealers from escaping the Space Hulk, which are over there somewhere. There's our two starting locations, so we'll just click deployment and such. So we have to deploy. We'll have a quick look around the map. As you can see, it's really, really, really dark. One of the things with the original game, rendition, the port of the board game, is that it was actually quite bright comparatively. So it's good to see they've gone really atmospheric with this one, and I really do like the fan blades and such like that. Anyway, we need to get to there, and I don't know how we're going to get there because we don't know the map, full map layout. We can roughly guess it, but we don't know it fully. Anyway, we need to deploy our first squad, so let's just put our main guy there, and then at the back we will put a couple of others as a flamer. I'll quickly run down the UI before we go any further, actually. So on the top left, objectives. Top right, we have our sort of cam. So that's our helmet cam. We can actually switch to heat mode, which is quite good. We'll switch it back to normal mode there. We can actually expand it and shrink it down. Now, I really do like that. If I click on this guy, you can see when I move forward, it does actually stomp, stomp, stomp. That's really good. I really, really like that. I love that about the first game, and this is even better because it feels more atmospheric the way it's done. And also, when they turn to fire, they don't now look at the ceiling, which was a really big beef that I had with the original. However, I'm going to turn that off now because it is a killer on the frame rate. It really does not like it. So now I'm just going to put a couple of scrubs in here because these are all just normal people. We don't really care about them ones. We do care, but we don't really. Anyway, we're just going to keep deploying all here. Now, I'm running this on
the Emperor's finest.
Not max. It's not maxed out, the graphics, but it is I think it's on... Well, it's insane. I think I've got it one level to that. I've got it on very high. But I've turned the volumetric lighting off because it is a dog for running. It runs absolutely terribly. Main criticism with it so far is it runs like a bag of hammers. Anyway, that's my experience anyway, and I know several people on the Steam forums have said the same thing. Why is it broken? It's all broken. But I think it's something to do with the volumetric lighting. There is now a ticky box to turn it off, and as soon as I do that, I got triple the frame rate. So, yeah, don't know whether it's my machine, but, you know, rather say it just for sake of completeness. Anyway, I forgot to run down the UI. The bottom left, we've got our... like skills and equipment tab, so you can see what they have, just in case you forgot what they are, because, you know, these are just three generic scrubs, so we don't want to, you know, they're all basically the same, but, oh, actually, no, you can see they've got different skills there. That one's got a little bit more in ballistic skill, that guy's got a little bit more in agility, is that? Yeah, a little bit more in agility, and it shows you our skills and equipment, so generally we've got the same, you've got the same equipment at the start, for the most part. Finally, right in the bottom left there, we've got our storm bolter, shows how much equipment we've got, and then a little picture of the gun, that'll generate heat as we fire. On the bottom, character selection, and turn on the right. So, we need to move these to get our objective. So we can click on them, and you can see these little pips there. These represent how many action points they have. We have a couple of orders. We can attack, we can overwatch, or we can just quick equipment. Huh. And we've got a servo skull scanner. Should we put that down? There we go. So we now deploy a servo skull scanner. So, can I move the servo skull scanner? Can I move him? No, it's just scanning around there. Should have moved it further forward. Anyway, we're just going to stomp forward like that, and here we go. Stomp, 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 stomp. Now, another criticism I had with the original game is, although it was quite accurate in terms of how Terminators move, it was a bit of a pain because they ran really, really, really slow, so it took them ages to actually get anywhere at all, and it was a little bit annoying. Regardless of how accurate you might think it is, it just wasn't that fun, and they've changed it now so you can pick your animation speed. In fact, if you want, you can change it so they'll go and just run super fast. Like, I don't like, it just looks as if someone's put chili powder down the back of the suits and they go, ah, and just like start charging away. So that has been resolved for people who were asking about that. So you can change animation speed. I think this is just on standard animation speed. In fact, I can actually check for you. Options. Let's have a quick look. It'll be... gameplay? Animation speed normal, yeah. So you can put up to max. Shall I put up to very fast? I'm going to show you this. We'll apply that. Right, so I'll just click end turn here. And then Gene Steele's turn. So are you ready for this? This is going to be insane. So, go. Look at them run there. Oh, that's insane. Right, you know what? I'm gonna change it back to what it was. We'll go to fast. There we go. No, standard one. Gene Steele's skin as well. Very nice. Yeah, advanced video. Change all the gamma and such. I haven't even fiddled around with that at all. Didn't even know that one was there. Right, you can spin your marines around anyway by clicking on them. Basically, wherever you... when you've got a marine selected, you can see you've got this box all around and you can just mouse over there and it tells you how far it's going to be. Also, it's two action points to go to there. So, one to go to there and I'm going to actually turn them for two. So, we'll go down there. Oh, good grief. It doesn't look like the... has the animation even saved? Did I save that? Apply. There we go. Right, cool. Anyway, so we are just... continuing moving forward. Now, I want to do it so... yeah, we're going to stomp in here now. And what I don't want to do is go really too far. Now, you have like a overall sense range, which is this thing around here. So, you generally can sense things coming. Now, I don't know where the Gene Stealers are, but I'm hoping they're not close. Anyway, we're going to stomp forward. We need to protect our flanks. Ah, there we go. We know there's some blips there. There's our blips. That's our, like, our perception there, this bar around here. So, we know there's some blips there. So, what I want to do... is get my blockage about there. So stompy, stompy, stomp. This is Rufus. I'm going to stompy, stompy, stomp to there. And then we are going to overwatch him. Okay? So now you can see we get a little overwatch marker. That's where he can actually see. And he's going to be watching that area. Now people are just going to pile right behind him. Because that's how we're going to do this. There we go. And you can... once you go off a marine, you can come back to the other one. So that's always a good thing. In the original board game, I believe once you've moved it, that's it, you're stuck. Click on overwatch on him, just in case the guy in front of him dies. And you see we've got little eyeballs on the top of them there too. To note that they're in overwatch. Right, we'll end the turn. And they're going to run right in front of me, and then we're going to blast them. So we missed the Gene Stealer, and then looks like he's attacked me, but I've defended it off. No, I haven't. No. No, he's actually killed me. And the Gene Stealer's ran straight towards me there, and then I managed to shoot him. But as you can see, he's still in overwatch, and we're still blattering away there. But we did lose one of our marines. He was teleported off, but as you can see, dead and dead. So, that's not good. What we need to do then is actually get round and see if we can defend this area. So if we can go to there, maybe? something like, ah, see, that's going to take 3 action points. Or rather, it isn't, because it sort of, it's a bit weird. It doesn't tell you the full amount of action points you have because of the, because of when you're on Overwatch, it already uses 2 points. So if you're on Overwatch, you actually got 2 more points than what you should have. I'm just going to move in here. I like the way, we're going to block this guy, are we? Yeah, we are there. Miss. Ah, we missed him. Damn it, that's not good. So, as you can see, when I move around the corner there, we actually fired automatically. That's still in the game Space Hulk. Originally the board game and obviously the game last year, whatever. It's really difficult. When I say Space Hulk, I'm now going to I'm referring to the game that came out a year ago, right? Anyway, with the original Space Hulk, when you move and turn and such, you automatically get to fire. In this one, you can just, you know, you can still fire as well. So if I mouse over that, you can see I've got bolt to fire, 84% to hit. Now, it gives me my all the bonuses, so you can see weapon, character, class, sustained fire bonus, which is, shooting it again. Also on the, because I've already fired that by turning and firing at it. On the right, you can see it says Rending Claw Gene Stealer, equipped with small diamond hard tip claws that tear armor and flesh, max AP and health, so one of one. I'm just going to pull trigger on this. And there it goes. Now, there was another issue that I had as well with the original. When you shot the guy in the chest, or if you missed, the bullets would go straight through and keep going and going and going through the entire Space Hulk, and it was just sloppy. I just didn't like it at all, and I think most people had that sort of feeling about it. So I'm glad that that's been resolved in this one. Really glad, in fact. Right, let's just move forward here. So who have we actually lost? We just lost, I think it was Anne Scrub. Yeah, just a normal Marine, nothing important. Well, actually, yeah, sort of important. I guess it's sort of important. Anyway, that's our flaming guy. I was going to put him Overwatch, but I can't. Anyway, so we've got, it looks like we've got some blips here. So we'll get Gaius, yeah, and we're going to walk him through the door. So I want to open it, in fact. I think I'll pull trigger on this one. What I'm going to do, I'm going to click attack, and there's different attack modes. So you've got bolt of fire, standard single shot, and then we have burst fire, which is multiple fire range, one blah, 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 4 shots, minus 10% to hit. So if you really want to get some, you can do that. And we've got aimed fire, it increases your chance to hit, but that costs 2 action points, and then we've got suppressive fire, which minuses their AP. So if you've got a really long corridor, then you can suppress fire them, and then that will slow them down. Now this guy's just a Rending Claw Gene Stealer. What I'm going to do, I'm not going to do anything other than, I'm just going to walk forward actually, and fire, and look at that, they don't half explode when that happens. We'll keep walking, and oh, that guy's there, that's not good, that's not good at all. What we're going to do then is, we're going to blat him. Here we go, there's a miss. Now, it looks like it did go through the wall just a little bit. Not a big problem. There we go. That's gone. What? Oh, yeah, he did explode. He's on the floor. I do like when you walk over them and they explode. Squish. I like that. Right, let's move forward here. And I think we're going to do the bad thing and sort of split up a bit. What I want to do is get, well, we're trying to get to there, and I don't know how to get there. So maybe keep the flanks covered with a couple of Marines, and then, yeah, a couple of Marines flank. We'll keep it, protected with a couple of Marines. And then, oh, there's stuff coming behind me now. That's always bad. Yeah, we'll keep the stuff flanked by a couple of Marines. So we'll turn there. Like that. Oh, that's not good. That one. Felix. Now, generally, you don't want to send your guys off on their own. And I really don't either. This is our main captain guy. So we're going to charge him down there. This one's going to go there. And this other guy, this is Felix, we're going to back up. Now, problem with backing up, does cost 2 AP, but you can back up now at least. And I'm not going to back up any further. I'm going to overwatch that location there. Right, this guy, we can't overwatch. I'll open the door though, and see, what can we see? We can't see anything, but when stuff comes around, we might be able to see it later on. Let's just charge forward to there, 4 AP. Now, obviously, these are supposed to be 2 squads, but because you can activate them in any order, it doesn't particularly matter. Let's overwatch that as well, and we'll get Cosmo. Cosmo? Why is that? Why does that? I'm sure I know the name Cosmo from something. Anyway, what I'm going to do, I'm going to get our other guy here to just turn. What can you see? There's nothing there. Okay, and I don't think there's anything around that corner anyway. Let's just go there. I'm going to turn there, squash that, and turn around. This other guy, Claudius, yeah, he's going to go to there, and I'm hoping we can turn around without any issues. Yeah, we should be alright, and then our flamethrower guy can go. He's quite quick, look how fast he is. We're going to take him to, I guess, there. Yeah, looks like you can't get around here. Yeah, as you can see, you can't get around there at all. If we open up the camera, we can see a better view of it. Look at that. What we'll do, we'll keep that open just for a little while. I'm going to click on this guy because I want to see. This is what he sees, okay? Ready? There you go. There's some firing over here. It switches to the guy that we're overwatching. There's more firing going down that corridor. Over there is the coming straight in that way. Oh, that's not good. Oh, yeah, that guy's sort of hurt.
No sacrifice.
Damn it. He's gone. So, that guy is gone. He was there. Or there, rather. That's not good. So we've only got our main marine guy to sort this out. This is our head honcho, but we'll... Oh, look at that. Oh, it's all slimy and horrible. Get some! Look at that. That's a good view. They've really improved that a lot. Right, let us overwatch that location. And we will keep moving in. Now, the problem is I've sort of run out of people I can realistically use for... a lot of this stuff, but I'm just going to have to keep charging them. I'm not really playing this very tactically. I'm just sort of doing it to show you how the game plays. Normally you can't... Well, it depends. You know, people have their own different styles of playing this game. Some people tend to charge stuff around. Some people prefer to do it really cautiously. Ah, there we go. We've got to overheat. Now, one of the new mechanics that's been added is overheating, okay? So you can see that weapon is now overheated and jammed. So every time you fire, your weapon will generate heat and you dissipate it at the start of your turn. So I've jammed that, so I need to unjam it, right? Which does take a fair amount of action points. Is how much? It takes 1 AP to do. You've got unlimited ammo, but you do only have a clip of 2... You know, basically, you've got 2 ammo of 20, and we're going to reload that as well. Now, I'm still on Overwatch, because what it does is it very sensibly reduces your action points so you don't accidentally do too many things, and then you end up using all of your Overwatch action points so you can't get back on. So I've managed to cool his weapon down twice and then reload it and still stay in Overwatch. Now, I must confess, I am not a fan at all of the overheat mechanic, and I'll tell you why. You currently have maximum bullets, right? You have 20 shots in this storm bolt, for example. Obviously, different weapons will have different ammo capacities, right? You also have this mechanic of heat, which is just the same sort of thing. Like, I don't understand why it's there. Well, I think it's there because when stuff comes around the corner, it means you can't just constantly overwatch and overwatch and overwatch and then that's it. But if the whole point was to reduce that, why didn't you just half the ammo capacity? Like, I don't really see the point in having an ammo and an overheat mechanic. I think it does the same sort of thing. So, I'm not sold on that. I'm really not sold on that. Anyway, let's just have a quick stomp round here. Now, this is not good because I'm actually using my... I'm using my flamethrower guy to come this way, which is not the best thing I could have done. Let's just get some normal marines down here. I call the marines actually terminators, aren't they? And that guy's facing the wrong way, which is not good. They're all stomping along. There we go. Stomp, 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 stomp. And we'll go there. I think that will come. I think we'll do it there. End the turn. And it'll take a little while until that's all sorted. And then, as you can see, stuff's coming around the corner. We are blackering away here. Look at that, exploding in the massive pile of gore. Don't know what they're firing at there. I think it's... Is it up there? Oh, yeah, it's up there. Wow. Okay, so we've still got more blips here. This guy's got all the experience in the world. Let me just quickly do a cooldown. As you can see, it's almost overheating, that one. So that what would happen if, say, that gene stealer came around the corner, that weapon would then overheat. Okay? But my argument is, why didn't they just give me 10 ammo capacity? It would do the same job, wouldn't it? Because instead of overheating after, say, 5 shots, it would overheat. It would just run out of ammo. Same sort of thing, I think. That's my take. Right. Let me just quickly run. Just quickly do that. We'll make sure we're not wasting any more. What I'm going to do is turn this guy around, actually. I don't really want him... Ooh, good. Unselect the movement thing. Unselect the movement thing.
Yes, brother. Moving.
Okay. That was a bit annoying. We'll turn him around to... Turn him around to there. And now we'll move forward. There we go. Right. Ah, there's a problem. You can see there is a... Gene Stealer, there, a blip. So what I'm going to do, move my flamethrower guy to... There.
Movement, brothers.
And then, I'm going to just pull the trigger on this one. So we've got several different modes of fire. Focus fire, long fire, and wide. think long will do it. So here we go.
That
really works. Oh yes. Yeah, that functions as a thing. That works, doesn't it? That really does work. Right, so I can't go any further forward because of that flame, and I've wrecked that. All these doors here, they're malfunctioning now because I've basically whacked it with a big pile of flame. Now I need to get over there somehow, but I don't know how to get there. What I'm going to do is move my flamethrower guy. I'll just move him further forward, actually. Then get the rest of the Marines to follow him, and hopefully we'll be alright. Face that. Stomping away now. And the problem I have is that there's only really one person defending this entire area. What I'm going to do, I'm going to send my main blokey bloke. No, I can't. He's out of AP. Out of AP. Oh well, I'll end the turn. So again, Overwatch guy blattering away here. And I think that's pretty much it. What I'll do then, I'll unjam that and just reload it. And we're just going to keep him there. And we'll get our main guy to stomp this way, I think. Now, like the original Space Hulk, you can actually shut them down. You can stop them spawning. Now, there's certain vents and such where they spawn from. If you get to that location, then you can shut them down if you're within so many spaces of it. Now, I don't know what's there, so I'm just going to go to... I'm going to go 4 AP to there, 3 AP to there. Ah, there we go. We know there's something there, because we can see through it. And then what I'm going to do... Overwatch. I like when you see them, you get this good. They actually power up the power fists. That's good. Right, let's go straight forward. We need to get in here pretty quick, pretty sharpish. There we go. And we'll call it a day there. End the turn, and they'll all stomp towards it. But it's very, very tactical. It is very, very tactical. It's very brutal. If you get it wrong, guess what? Your Marines start dying. I mean, you saw one point back here. Back there where I tried to I thought I'd be okay just standing around and not going Overwatch because I ran out the action points. Doesn't work like that. You get got. Ah, lots of Marines. Oh, lots of aliens coming from this way. So I do have an option to... Do I flame it again? Problem with flaming it is then it does take a little while for me to get there. So what I'm going to do, turn him round and walk forward. Bam, 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 bam. Keep walking forward. And we're going to keep walking forward with these guys as well. Now, I want to get someone on Overwatch here. So, we'll move Philo down and then... Why can't I Overwatch? Ah, crap, because he's the guy with the flamer. Ah, balls that right up. You can't Overwatch with a flamer. If you're wondering what other weapons there were, or what they are, rather, then ones that I have... seen, not used myself, but seen in like trailers and things like that. You've got assault cannons. I believe you can go to equipment anywhere. When you can actually click on their equipment anywhere and you can see it. I'll show you that later on anyway. We need to get this other guy moved. No, I don't. I'll just keep him on Overwatch. We'll end the turn there. I think, we've still got ones to move, haven't we? Move him further forward. This is our Romanus.
Going into Overwatch.
We will
jump
and reload. And end the turn. Oh, good job we put him on Overwatch because they're coming down this way. Gene Steel is sighted. Not lasting long. Look at that. They're coming down that corridor and they're just getting absolutely blasted. Excellent. Right. So, this guy. Charging straight forward. We're not going to mess around here. Charging straight forward onto our objective. And we need to activate it, but we need 1 AP to do so. So we can't do that yet. I'm going to then move another Marine down to there and turn him. Ah, there we go. That's a spawn point for Gene Stealers. Once we get within that circle, it will stop them. So we need to do that.
Acknowledged.
He understands. He knows. Right, our other guy. Why can't I move him? You, move there. There we go, we can. And I think... Move a little bit further forward.
Objective logged.
Yeah, objective logged. And we will... Oh, don't need to reload.
Let them come.
Just put him on Overwatch. Get another Marine down there. Check him. Yeah, he's fine. Are they coming from the back anywhere? We'll quickly do that, as you might imagine. And... See, so far there's nothing behind me. Oh! Yep, that's getting... That's flattering there. Yep, we are definitely hitting them there. What I'm going to do, I'm actually going to activate our servo scope. we go. And that'll scan around. Nope, not finding anything. Right, what I need to do then is get him to activate that. That's plant explosives. Explosives are now down, okay? Excellent. What I need to do with this guy is... Tonk it as fast as possible. Because we need to block that area, which we have now. So that should be pretty... That should be pretty much this mission done, I believe. We'll just keep stomping marines around. And then, again, check these guys. Make sure that they are reloaded and still on Overwatch. Now he is, because I did an action that broke Overwatch. There are some actions that will break Overwatch, obviously, like moving and such. Can I do anything more with him? Deploy the scanner. Little servo skull. I do like the little servo skulls. Little sonar. Oh, look at that. Look at that long-range fire. Excellent. They're actually out of our scanning range as well, our perception range, but we are still hitting them because this is technically still in line of sight. Right, so one marine in here, four action points, stomp, 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 and we should be able to, as soon as we get this one done. Done. Excellent. We've got some achievements as well. Again, when I last played this, we didn't even have achievements in it. Right, so we get mission report, total kills and all that sort of thing. Experience, you can see they leveled up. We'll click continue. We'll just skip all that. Bang, 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 Michael Bay, bang, bang, bang. I don't know why that reminds me of a Michael Bay film or the Horn of Doom. Right, so anyway, we've done that mission. And as you can see now, we've got two choices we can do for sever the limb from the body, plant explosives to dislodge a section of the Space Hulk. Okay, taking force of the aliens with it. And contact has been lost with the cat unit carrying vital data. The cat is evil, right? Everyone who's played Space Hulk knows that the cat is a horrible, evil, just rage-inducing thing. It's horrible. I hate the cat. Anyway, we've leveled up. As you can see, we can... Click on that. I can't get a combi bolter and plasma gun. That would be quite good. However, we can get a power sword. Oh yes, ready for battle. So, we can now go to our attributes and we can level the attributes up. So this is our main commander. So, increase our willpower maybe. I don't think we need to do that for him. Not weapon skill either. Agility, perception, toughness. I think for the commander, we probably want to go perception because we don't really want to keep him at the back. And it shows you how many points it's going to cost to level up. So 2 and 3, it's basically whatever level it is. Go for willpower as well. There we go. And we can get to our main flamer guy. We're blatantly going to... Well, there's no point in getting hit chance. Might as well give him an extra agility point and call it there. Skills. What can we pick? Got some more skills here. Incinerator increases the flame ammo by 4. By 2. And door breacher. Well, we'll give him that. We'll give him that incinerator. Nice, nice. Can we get him any other equipment? He could actually have a chain fist if he wanted to. And there's the assault cannon there. We've also got these ones on the top. Cyclone missile launchers. I could be wrong, but that might be limited to the Ultramarines, but I'm not entirely sure. Anyway, I think I will call it there. I think it's all right. I like it more. It's weird because I didn't think when I saw it that I'd actually like it as much as I did. I thought, oh, it's just going to be a bit of a board game ripoff. It's not going to be as good. The thing is, if you want to just play the board game, then here's the thing. I always say, then play the bloody board game. It's always going to be better, even if it's just because you're in the same room with your mates playing the game, right? I think it's always preferable to play the physical stuff first, with one or two exceptions. But if you wanted to just play the board game, then the previous Space Hulk game did that for you. Although it did have some issues, and certain things I wasn't fussed, and I think I've covered them in this video, that generally it did what it wanted to do. This doesn't have multiplayer, it's just single player, but it's a different type of experience. There's some things I'm still not convinced on, like the whole heat mechanic. I think it's sort of redundant. I think you could have done the same job with just the ammo thing. I really like that you can select the different chapters, and there's a lot of actual game in it. There's a lot of missions. It doesn't really run that well for me, but, other people have said the same thing, I believe, on Steam forums and whatnot, but I think they're working on all that. So, overall, yeah, I think it's alright. If you're looking for... I guess some people, I think unfavorably, sort of called it XCOM, and I don't get that. It's got action points, and it's a tactical game. I think that's where the sort of similarity ends, really. But yeah, I think it's all right. I do think it's all right. Some people will not be happy that they've taken some elements from the board game and chopped others out and added more, but as I said, it's an evolution of the Space Hulk rather than just a straight copy. A straight copy already exists, so there's no point in doing the same thing. Overall, yeah, I think it's alright. Links are in the description so you can check it out yourself. I would really like to see more chapters. I mean, everybody has their own personal chapter, and sadly, Ravens aren't in it yet. So as soon as they add them in, then I might come back to that one. But, you know, we'll have to see about that, won't we? As I said, comments in the comments. Links in the description for the game. Thanks very much for watching. Take care. And generic partings.